Yeah, so what are the human factors, the psychological factors that make us make the decisions that we do? And just when we think we understand what they are, we find out that we really don't. And I think that it's a whole new world with psychology today and neuroscientists seeing how complex the brain really is and how it really works in the brain. And I think we're just at the very first baby steps of understanding all of this. You know, we used to think, okay, it's all about biases and mental shortcuts, or heuristics, as this is called. And people like Ian McCammon have been very good at communicating those things that have been learned in other fields back to the Avalanche community. And so we're just discovering this. One thing I really disagree about in the Avalanche business is a lot of times we shame people for triggering avalanches. And for many years we've been teaching that if you're triggering an avalanche, you're doing something wrong, which is obviously true, but we shouldn't shame people because we're all humans. We all make mistakes. Everybody makes mistakes. I mean, I make mistakes constantly. I mean, my wife would attest to that in a second if she was here. And there's nothing wrong with making mistakes. That's how we learn. But if we make mistakes in a high consequence situation, sometimes those mistakes can be deadly. But that's nothing to be ashamed about, because every one of us makes mistakes. Most avalanche professionals I know have been caught in an avalanche a time or two, and so have I. And so it's natural when you trigger an avalanche and you're caught in an avalanche, you're embarrassed and you want to cover it up. And I've done that myself in the past, and it's just not a very productive thing to do. You need to come clean with it and talk about it, get it out in the community and say, hey, I triggered an avalanche and everybody else needs to know about it. It's dangerous out there. And these are the mistakes that I made, and don't make these mistakes too. So that way everybody can learn about it. So at the Utah Avalanche Center, we never put people in a shameful situation. We say, oh, that's great, you reported the avalanche, and we'll get the information out there. We never use their real name. We just, you know, we don't care who you are or what happened. We just want to know the information. We just want to know, are you triggering avalanches? What kind of avalanches were they? What kind of slopes were they on? So that they can save other people's lives. And we never shame people, because every one of us has made these same mistakes. Professionals make them as well. So you should never feel ashamed of triggering an avalanche, because everybody does it.